was introducing her, I mentioned that Megan was the 2003 Female Co-Athlete of the Year. Our next honoree, Mrs. Leighann Reilly Weill, held that honor with her. As a member of the class of 2003, Leighann was a four-year varsity member of our girls' tennis team. She was a four-time All-Conference and All-Parochial selection and a three-time All-South Jersey selection. She is a two-time Camden County singles champion and a member of two state championship teams. She was named Player of the Year in 2002 by South Jersey Tennis Coaches Association and finished with 122 career wins. Upon graduation, she enjoyed continued athletic success at Villanova University, where she was named the 2006 College Player of the Year by the South Jersey Tennis Coaches Association. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. Leighann Reilly Weill, accompanied by our Assistant Athletic Director, Mr. Frank Del Rossi, who will present the plaque for Leighann.
Giving this award specifically for Coach D for nominating me for the award in the first place. I want to congratulate all my fellow inductees. In particular, I do want to congratulate Megan Foster. I had the privilege of having Megan as a friend, not only in high school and sharing my sports experiences with her, but also in attending Villanova with her. We lived in the same dorm room our freshman year, and so I got to witness all of her athletic endeavors through our years together, both high school and college. So congrats, Megan. Before coming to Eustace, I had already started playing tennis, and tennis is an interesting sport. Before coming to Eustace, I was used to playing tennis as an individual sport. It's just you on the court, you don't have a team. There's no substitutes, there's no referees or line judges, there's no coaching during the match, it's just you on the court. So when I was entering Eustace as a freshman, I thought, how exactly is this gonna work when I'm gonna play a sport that's individual, but now I have to be on a team? In my first couple weeks of the training that was preseason, Coach Del Rossi explained that you're gonna have challenge matches against your teammates. And I thought, okay, so you have to battle your teammate first, and out of the 20 girls, 7 of us get spots, and that's it. How is that gonna work? How are we gonna function as a team after the fact? I then found out that if we played our teammates throughout the season in any tournaments, that counts as an automatic challenge match too. So, I thought it was going to be a very confusing time when I first started, as how are we going to gel together as a team? I also thought, who is this crazy man who decided to coach 20 girls who are going to be battling each other and trying to conduct themselves as a team throughout a season? But only someone with the talents of Coach D could do that, and he definitely was a great selection that I was just blessed to have as a coach for my 4 years when I was at Eustace tennis player. But entering my freshman year at Eustace, I learned a lot of stuff. I participated in those challenge matches, and they weren't always easy. I had to be the only freshman on an all-upperclassmen team, and you got to select if you challenged or not. So at the end of every match that I played during my first couple weeks, Coach D would say, okay, are you good now? Are you set in the lineup? And I'd go, give him the love, maybe I'll challenge again. And he would just shake his head and be like, all right, here's another challenge match. So my freshman year was a little rough. My last challenge match, I had played a senior, and when I was taking her spot, I remember sitting on a bench by myself, and the rest of the team was with my teammate who had just lost her spot as a senior. And I didn't really know how to react, and I thought, this is going to be a rough 4 years if I'm sitting by myself on a bench and the rest of the team is over there consoling someone else. But it turned out to be the best learning experience, and one that gave me the foundation and tools that I needed to make my Eustace tennis career successful, as well as my Villanova tennis career successful. It also made tennis as a team member one of the most influential and memorable moments of my life. When I was at Eustace, Coach D and the rest of my teammates and I did become close. While my freshman year was a little rough, the next 3 years were ones that I will always cherish and remember forever. They taught me how to be a leader and how to be a teammate. They taught me integrity and how to play with passion while remaining compassionate. They taught me humility and that selflessness is that there's no individual win that's greater than our team win. And again, coming from a sport where you're used to being on a court by yourself, these were tools that were invaluable to me, not only on the tennis court, but throughout the rest of my career in education, in life, in my job, and I couldn't be more grateful for Eustace giving me that first opportunity to learn so many of that tools for all the benefits that they've given me in the last 15 years of my life. Interestingly enough, as I've continued to grow in the last few weeks, the only thing that fits me right now is my senior year field day shirt that is blue, and on the back says the tradition is that of a winner. So I'm a little confused with how that sizing worked back then, but that's what fits me right now. And that's what got me thinking, what is that tradition of a winner? And it's all the things I listed, from learning to put humility and selflessness, and that no individual win was greater than the team win, that was the tradition that I took with me after I left here, and that is the win that I will always remain closest to my heart. We've had a lot of big family events in my family this year, and one of which was my wedding. And, sorry for everything. And one of those things that I had mentioned in one of those speeches were that my family has always stressed that in life, the three greatest things are your family, your friends, and your faith. And it's through all these things have been afforded to me through my playing of tennis, both here at Eustace and at Villanova. My faith, I had the privilege of going to this Catholic institution as well as Villanova, another Catholic institution, where faith has always been at the core of all of our values. It's the core value of my family, it's the core value in my education system, and it's one that you can't always get everywhere, but it's the time and the energy that you put into learning that faith and keeping it close to you that has made me strong through all of my endeavors. When it comes to friends, they also are a very important thing that my parents have said to always keep close to me. One of those seniors who was my captain when I was a freshman, we then also went on to play at Villanova together, and her husband became my coach my senior year, and her son was just the ring bearer at my wedding. And so it goes to show that even though my freshman year was rough, that you know these are friends that I make for the rest of my life, and they will remain my friends for the rest of my life. There's even players that I played against at different high schools and in my junior career that we had to play each other on the court, but at the end of the day, friendship was more important than that. And that's what I keep going back to. And all of them are still in my life, and I couldn't be more grateful. Even seeing some people here tonight who I just remember their faces from walking the halls of Eustace, I think Eustace is a family, and they always will remain close friends to me. The biggest gift that, of the three that my family always says to keep most important is that family. Family has always been what's most important, and it will remain the most important. I want to thank my family who are all here today. But first, I learned that it's not just my sporting endeavors that made my family so close. Sports have been huge in my family, whether it was supporting my tennis endeavors, supporting my sisters, my family's love for college basketball. Sports are something that can really bring people together, whether you're young, whether you're old, whether you have a different viewpoint. It's really something that can make you feel like a family, even if you're not related by blood. So I want to thank my family, I want to thank my parents and my sister for all their love, encouragement, and never-ending support. They're at every one of my practices and matches in high school, and I continue through college. They're dedicated to me and give me unconditional love and support that I could have never dreamed of. And I want to thank them for making all of my tennis dreams come true, all of my education dreams come true, and just for always supporting me no matter what choices I made. I have to thank my grandmother who just passed. She was at all of my matches, and she would cross every one of her fingers, every one of her toes, just to give me the luck that I needed. And I wish that she was here today, but I know she's with me in spirit. I want to thank my aunts and my cousins and my uncles for always supporting me and coming here tonight. So many years later, I haven't been on the tennis court in quite some time. I kind of can't right now, but I'll get back there, I promise. But I want to thank them for just always showing their love. They never cared if I won or lost. They just wanted to be there to support me. So I really appreciate it. And then Coach D. Coach D is a true one-of-a-kind man, I tell you. Like I said, have 20 girls on the team who are battling each other nonstop and have to act as a team afterwards. There's no other man who has a special touch than he did to have a team that was as strong as us. We were all friends. At the end of the day, we knew how to put down our rackets and continue those friendships both off the court and while we were in the classroom. It didn't matter what group of friends we were in, we all gelled together. It was just a really wonderful experience. Coach D was my first coach that I was allowed to have as a coach on the court. I was never allowed to speak to anyone during my matches. It would just be me out there. And it was my first time I had someone who could come up and shake me up a little bit. And he was always supportive and always was my calming force while I was on the court. He would give me words of wisdom that I was searching for when I'd be down in certain matches. And I can even remember one match he had to leave for a wedding. And I was like, you're leaving me? In the middle of the match, like, you're leaving me? When I was so used to it just being realized, you know, how meaningful he was during my coaching career, because before that I was always used to being by myself. But after having experienced Coach D on the court and him having all the wisdom and the knowledge to help me bring me back to a positive place when I was feeling low in the game was something that I couldn't have asked for and I really appreciate. He gave me the comfort and the confidence that I needed in every match, and he was always there to support me and to give me the bigger outlook of life. If there were certain players that I had to play against in the area who were my friends, and who were my friends and juniors, and when I had to play them up against each other, it was tough for me. But he always helped me to block that out and say, you know, focus on the match and you'll be good to go. But I just want to say I couldn't have had a better high school tennis career if it wasn't for Coach D, and I wouldn't have wanted it any other way. So congrats again to everybody tonight, and thank you very much for this.